guys, welcome to my channel, Safe Travel RV. I'm Big Al. How many of you guys enjoyed cooking in this RV oven? I bet there's not many, and I bet the reason is because the food burns. And if you remember my video, 7 Fun Ways to Cook When RV Camping, I pointed out that it's because the burner assembly is so close to that bottom rack that it just tends to burn the food. We've only cooked like maybe 2 times in this oven, or let me say we've only blackened 2 times in this oven. They were cinnamon rolls and a pizza, and they both turned out terribly. So this is an upgrade we've been wanting to do, so we're going to get started on this today, and we're going to show you how to do it. This whole assembly is one piece. The 3 burner stovetop and oven, it all comes out as one assembly. What I'm going to replace the oven with is this little guy right here. It's a Cuisinart air fryer, toaster, oven, and grill. I'm sure a lot of you have one. We have one in our house. We usually don't even use our oven anymore. This thing is awesome for cooking. So that's going to replace our oven. We'll have to run power for that. And then on my cooktop, at this point, I'm undecided if I'm going to go with a 2 burner gas drop-in or a 3 burner gas slide-in with the knobs all out here on the front, similar to what you see here. So we're just deciding which way to go. If I do the 2 burner drop-in, I'm going to have to build up some type of trim right here for it to rest on. But once I get all this out and verify my measurements, then we're going to see exactly what's going to work in here, and then we'll go with the install. So if you guys are ready to up your RV cooking, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is make sure your propane is turned off at the source. Then you need to kill your 12 volt power supply to this cooktop, because that's what runs the lights on the front of this unit, okay? The spark igniter, I think, is a piezoelectric spark igniter, so it does not require any power. It has its own power built in. But let's do those 2 things first for safety. And then the next step is to remove this grate. You just simply lift it up like that and set it out of the way. And then on your glass cooktop, you close it back down. If you look back in the back corners, there are these 2 black rubber tabs. You just kind of lift that up just like that, and this whole unit lifts right out completely. Okay, now that's going to expose our 2 connections that we need to break first. One being the gas line, and I'll show you up close on that. And then the other one's going to be our 12 volt power supply, which is right here. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is cut my electrical connection here. Leave a bit of a pigtail on there in case I ever want to reconnect it. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is remove this gas line connection right here. You're going to need 2 wrenches, a 13/16 and a 3/4. You always want to back up this connection when you're moving it so you don't cause any damage, okay? So lefty loosey, comes right undone. Then you can just unscrew it the rest of the way. Push that gas line out of the way. And you might want to put a baggie and a rubber band over the end of that just so no dirt or dust gets in there, messes you up down the road. Okay, next step is to remove these screws and slide this unit out of here. Okay guys, we got that oven out of there. It was pretty easy. 4 screws was all it was holding that thing in there. So we got it out of there. After taking some measurements, I decided we're going to go with this one you're looking at right here, the Rec Pro RP2217, the 3 burner slot drop-in cooktop. The width is perfect for it. The depth is fine. There's about 3/4 of a gap across hit the back. I'm going to have to fill in with something, but that's not a big deal. So that'll go right in there. The main thing is for my air fryer down here, I'm gonna have to build a solid shelf, because this is just no support whatsoever. So I gotta build a solid shelf here. This gas line and this electrical has to be back in here, because like I said, I need all this space. There's also enough slack in my power right here that I probably can put a box right there. Surface mount box right there. And that power, I know it's gonna be good 110 volt, because the receptacle is right there. And that's the one that we always use for our toaster oven, our coffee pot. So I know there's enough amperage in that circuit. to handle it. So we will just tap in right here. Either one of these, because it's just a loop circuit, we'll tap into there for our power for the air fryer. And then we'll get everything installed and see about doing any trim around here. Okay, so our three burner cooktop came in from a Rec Pro. I want to thank them for sending this out for us to evaluate. It is the model number RP-2217. Okay, so let's just open this thing up and see what we got in here. It took about 4 days, free shipping. So this is called the Greystone, okay? This is the Greystone. We're just gonna go ahead and take it out of the box. All right, this looks really nice. It's got the smoked glass top, which is very similar to what is in there. This is your instruction manual. It's got a really nice cast iron grate. I like that. That's really nice. But I'll tell you what I really like about this, it's back here on the back. Your gas line is on the correct side, and then your 12 volt for your stove light is on the correct side. So easy hook up, you slide it right in. So just remember, go to their website, recpro.com, and if you use the code BIGAL5, you'll get 5% off of this order or anything in their store. And they sell everything RV related, so it's a great website to visit. All right, I'm ready to get this thing installed. Okay, let me show you what I've done here. I just added a receptacle back here in the corner because I had a convenient wire to tie into, but that's not necessary. You don't have to do that. You can just use a short extension cord that's approved by Cuisinart to plug in your air fryer. They actually say that's allowed in the brochure. So I did that, and then this is just paneling right here, so it's not strong enough to support it. So I took half inch plywood and I notched it out, and it's going to go in there and make a nice solid floor. And then to kind of fill this in a little bit, I cut these little pieces that I can use for trim. And as you can tell, it doesn't really look like it's going to work very well, right? How am I going to max that up, right? Okay, well, I got a big out tip for you. Most RV manufacturers make stuff like this. It's called seam tape. It's 6 inches wide. You buy it by the foot, and it's going to match everything up. So this will look like it's factory, okay? I've already made this piece up, and it's going to work really well. But let's talk about clearance to combustibles. Now, with Greystone, on their cooktop, in their manual, they specify how much you need around combustibles, okay? You got to adhere to that. That's important. But on Cuisinart, the only thing they say is don't drape any materials that are combustible over the cooktop, and don't use it underneath a cabinet. Okay, we've got the two side trim pieces in. We got the plywood floor in. I've notched out right here. This is what I removed, which will allow this tray to go in and out. And folks, that tray is the trick to this whole job being safe and working well with your Cuisinart air fryer. Go to Amazon and do a search for the Penn Elcom R1290/IU sliding rack. This will fit in there perfect. It has a max weight of 41 pounds. Your air fryer weighs 20 pounds, so it'll be perfect for that. On the install, it's very simple. I just made a couple little aluminum brackets right there to attach it in the back. In the front, it attaches to the existing piece of trim, as you can see right there. Let me just tell you, when you're measuring for your cutout, you need to allow for that piece right there that comes out along beside it. So allow like 3/16 to 1/4 inch clearance on both sides, and that will allow that tray to slide right on out. Let's look over here at this cooktop and see what we need to do to install it. All right, so the first thing you want to do is this is going to have to come off, and there's a screw here and a screw here. And that takes that off, and it allows you to get back there in the back to your gas line and your power line. And then this tray here has four screws that you'll take out. That allows you to pull this trim piece off here and put four screws into the side of the walls to mount this thing. And I might add that this is really a nice feature that they did here. It'll prevent any liquid when it does boil over, if it does, from going down into the burner part of the. It's got a little tray here that catches any liquids that come out. So that's going to be really nice. Okay, so installing this Greystone 3-burner cooktop is pretty straightforward. You can use those four screws that you use to take the oven out. Just make sure it's centered in the opening and slides right in. Then you got your electrical back there and your propane connection back here. So before you use this unit, you need to test for gas leaks. Now, unless you're a heat and air person or an RV inspector, you're not going to have a manifold pressure test kit or a gas sniffer. So I test this to make sure there's no leaks, I'm going to turn my gas on here. So we know that device is working. So if you don't have either one of those test kits, I would go to your local RV center or contact your propane supplier and see if you can just bring your unit over there and have them check that connection right there. And while they're at it, just check the whole stovetop to make sure that you don't have any gas leaks. Okay, let's wrap this thing up.
Okay guys, we are finished with this installation. Let's check out the oven first. This air fryer pulls right out, gives you plenty of air circulation while you're cooking. Then when you're done, you can just push it right back in. And to hold it in place while you're going down the road, you'll just need to make you a little brace that slips right in behind the trim, just like that. And that'll keep that from coming out, okay? All right, let's move up here to the cooktop. Again, I want to thank Rec Pro for providing this for us. We're going to be very happy to use it. Just make sure before you light your burners that you fold this glass cover all the way back, okay? We have found that it lights very quickly. It has a nice even blue flame. We love the cast iron grate. It really gives us a solid cooking surface, okay? The only thing I did notice with this product is there's a little bit of rattling with the glass on the cast iron grate, especially in motorhomes going down the road. So what you need to do is get you some of this Grip Premium. It's a rubberized shelf liner. You can use it all over your RV. It works great. Just cut your piece to fit and then you just lay it right in here and then close your glass cooktop, your glass cover back down over it, and then it's solid, okay? So no rattling. When you get to your destination, you can just pull that out, close this back down, and lay this on top of it, and you got your nice surface to put other things on. Okay, well that's it, folks. I hope you like the install. If you have any questions while you're doing it yourself, please send me a message and I'll be glad to help you with it. So until then, we'll see you on the road and safe travel.